one born on the self-same day, how one was kept, one given away. And you can never hear how the Johnsons died, never knowing they shared one name until the day they died, when a mother cried, my own dear son's last sight. And you can never hear a mother, so cruel as a stone in place of a heart. And bring her on, and come, judge for yourselves how she came to play this part.
Once I had a husband, he goes to go to the shop.
All right.
I met him at a dance, and now he came on with the chap.
Me were a dancer, what did he show me?
Said me eyes were deep as pools, his skin as soft as snow.
Lovely.
He told me I was sexy on the Carolyn Monroe. And we were dancing.
Dancing, la la la.
is a pretty house, isn't it?
It's a pity it's so big.
I'm finding it rather large at present.
Oh, yeah. Well, Mr. Lyons being away in that. When did he come back, Mr. Lyons?
Oh, it seems such a long time. The company sent him out there for 9 months, or was that?
We've got him about 5 months, huh?
Oh, you'll be glad when it's back, won't you? The house won't feel so empty then, will it?
Actually, Mrs. Jamie, we'll just lie down for it. Well, for the children, before children would come along.
Well, we might still be able to.
Oh, no, I'm afraid. We've been trying for such a long time now. I wanted to adopt, but Mr. Lyons is... Well, he says he wants his own son, not somebody else's. Myself, I believe an adopted child could become one, though.
Oh, yeah. Hey, it's weird, though, isn't it? Yes, you can't have kids, and me, I can't stop having them. My husband used to say that all they had to do was shake hands and I'd be in the club. Well, he must have shook hands with me before he left. I'm having another one, you know.
Oh, I see.
Oh, but look, it's all right, Mrs. Lyons. I'll still be able to do my work. I mean, having babies is like clockwork to me. I'm back on my feet and working the next day, you know. And if I have this one at the weekend, I won't even need to take one day off. Well, look, this job, I can just manage to get by now. Jesus Christ, Mrs. Lyons, what are you trying to do?
No, that's right.
The shoes.
Pardon?
New shoes on the table. Take them off. Oh, God, Mrs. Lyons. Never put new shoes on the table. You never know what'll happen.
You mean nothing to me?
No. But you never put new shoes on the table.
Look, if it'll make you any happier, I'll put them away.
The shoes up on the table. And a joker in the pack. The salt has been spilled and a looking glass cracked. There's one lone black eye over there. The mother said.
I'm not superstitious.
The mother said.
Oh, what are you doing here? The milk bill's not due till Thursday.
Actually, I've given up the milk round and gone into medicine. I'm your gynecologist. Okay, honey, let's have a little listen to the baby's ticker, shall we?
I was dead worried about having another baby, you know, Doctor. I didn't see how we were going to manage with another mouth to feed, but now that I've got my little job, we'll be okay. If I'm careful, we can just manage to scrape by, even with another mouth to feed.
Mouths, Mummy?
What?
No, no, Mrs. Johnson, mouths to feed. You're expecting twins, congratulations. And the next one, please, nurse!
One more baby we could have managed to... Not with two. The welfare have already been on to me. They say I'm incapable of controlling the kids I've already got. They say I should put some of them into care, but I won't. I love them. I love the bones of every one of them. I'll even love these two when they come along, but... Well, like they say at the welfare, kids can't live on love alone.
Twins. You're expecting twins.
How quickly an idea plans it can take root and grow into a plan. The thought conceived in this very room grew as surely as a seed in a mother's womb.
Please. and you'd like desperate to have a baby.
Each day I look up on this window, I see with dread I've been before. I rush out, but as I fold my arms around you, it's gone. Will he ever there fall? I've dreamed of all the places
I haven't got it.
You shouldn't have served for all the stuff, should you?
You knew you wouldn't be able to pay, didn't you?
Well, when I got the job, I thought I would be able to pay. When I went in the showroom, we only meant to come out with a couple of things, but when you're standing there, it all looks so nice. And when you look in the catalogue and there's 6 months to pay, it seems years away. And you need a few things, so you sign.
Yeah, well, you bloody well shouldn't.
I know I shouldn't, yet stop, get. I've spent all my bleeding life knowing I shouldn't, but I do. Now take your fucking wireless and get off.
Bonnie, Stockwell, I am sorry.
Oh, it's all right, lad, you're used to it. We were in the middle of our tea one night when you arrived to take the table.
Well, as long as you can laugh about it, that's the main thing, isn't it, eh?
Oh,
proud, aren't you?
Yes. Yes, I am. Aren't I, Edward? I'm proud of Jennifer, too.
Oh, he's lovely. Oh, look, he wants to be picked up.
No, no, he's fine, Mrs. Justin. He doesn't have to be picked up.
But he's going to cry.
He's picking up. I should pick him up, all right.
Yeah, just so long.
Yes, well, has the bathroom been done? Time to set him up.
Yeah.
Darling, it's going to be hard on the woman. She only wanted to hold the baby. All women like to hold babies, don't they?
Well, I don't want her to hold the baby, Richard. She... Well, I don't want her to catch anything. The baby catch things very easily, Richard.
Oh, that's all right. You know best.
Did you see her as much as I do? But she's always fussing over him. Any opportunity, she's coming and having it. Well, as if she were his mother. But she's always bothering you, Richard, always. And since the baby arrived, she has much of a
bother. Come on. Come on. It's all right, Jennifer. You're just a little... It's this depression thing that happens after a woman's had a baby.
I'm not depressed, Richard. It's just that she makes me... Richard, well, I think she should go.
And what will you do to help in the house?
Well, I'll find someone else, find someone who doesn't spend all day fussing over the baby.
Oh, well, I suppose you know best. The house is your domain. Look, Jen, I've got a board meeting. I really must dash.
Oh, Richard! Can you let me have some cash?
Oh, of course.
Oh, I need about £50.
My God! What for?
I've got lots of things to buy for the baby. I've got the nursery sorted out.
All right. All right.
Justin. Mrs. Johnson, would you come down here for a moment, please? Oh, sit down. Richard and I have been talking it over, and well, the thing is, we both think it would be better if you left.
Left where?
It's your work. Your work is deteriorating, but I work the way I've always worked.
Well, I'm sorry, we're not satisfied.
What will we do? How will we live without my job?
Oh, yes, well, we thought of that.
Here's... Oh, it is a lot of money. Well...
All right, Mrs. Lionel, if I'm going, I'm taking my son with me.
No, no, I'm not! And it is my son, mine!
Well, I'm going to tell someone. I'm going to tell the police. I'll bring the police.
Oh, no, no, you won't! You didn't.
You're very
But don't you realise what a crime that is? You must stop.
You sold your baby!
I didn't! You told me! You said I'd be able to see him every day!
Well, I'm going to tell someone. I'm going to go...
No, you're telling nobody!
Because if you tell anyone, and these children learn the truth, well, you know what will happen, don't you? You do know what they say about twin secretly parties, don't you?
Well,
they say... They say that if the twin learns that he was one of the men, then they shall both immediately die. It means, Mrs. Johnson, that these brothers shall grow up unaware of the other's existence. They shall be raised apart and never ever told what was once the truth.